والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His ultimate and most beautiful wisdom, chose particular times and particular places to have a virtue over others. So for example, Mecca and Medina have a virtue over other places. A person who offers a salah in Masjid al-Haram has a reward of equal to 100,000 prayers. And that is a virtue over Al-Medina, which if a person offers their salah there, it is equal to 1,000 prayers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses certain places over others. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses certain seasons, certain times in the year, which have a virtue over others. Now from these very special times is the month of Dhul-Hijjah, which is the last of the Islamic months in the calendar year. Now we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran that there are 12 months in the year, and that these 12 months were decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, that the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. That however, مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمٌ, however there are four of these 12 months which are sacred months. Now what do we mean by sacred months? First and foremost, we need to identify what are these sacred months. There are three which are together, and then there is one which is on its own. So we have towards the end of the year, we have Dhul-Qi'dah, Dhul-Hijjah and Muharram. These are three of the four sacred months. And then the seventh month of the Islamic calendar is Rajab. So these are the four sacred months within the year. From these four, Dhul-Hijjah has the greatest status from these particular months. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us similarly in the same verse in Surah At-Tawbah that ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ, that this is the true religion. And in these sacred months, فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ, so therefore do not oppress and wrong yourselves during these months. Now this obviously doesn't mean that during the other months it is allowed for you to wrong yourself. But what is meant here in this beautiful verse is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to be very careful, to be very watchful, that in these particular sacred months that sins are not increased in number, but the sins are increased in their magnitude. Meaning that if a person is to commit sins during this time, it is seen as an even bigger sin. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us not to commit these sins, not to oppress in these particular times. If a person is fasting during the month of Ramadan and is engaged in foul speech, it is seen as a greater wrong that this special time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed for us, you should be more wary of yourself. So within these 4 months, as we mentioned, Dhul-Hijjah is the most sacred. Why it is the most sacred? It is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed that the pilgrimage, the Hajj, is to be performed at this particular time. It is the opportunity for us as Muslims to remind ourselves of the footsteps of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, Abu al-Anbiya, the father of the prophets. And the pilgrimage, the Hajj itself, was even known to the people of al-Jahiliyyah before Islam, the pre-Islamic times. They knew that this was a very special time. However, their understanding of how to perform the pilgrimage was lost and was distorted. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with the true teachings of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to remind us what we should be doing during these very, very special times. So as these days and these months, they come up upon us, we remind ourselves that the very first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah are the very best 10 days of the entire year. All of us think about the blessings of Ramadan and the last 10 nights of Ramadan and Laylatul Qadr, but very few of us prepare sufficiently concerning the blessings of the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. These are the most beloved days to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No good action is done during this time that is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than this time. So brothers and sisters, let us prepare ourselves for this time inshallah ta'ala and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeking His reward, His forgiveness, trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and having hope in Him, and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our deeds. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq, success during this time. Allahumma ameen. Barakallahu feekum.
والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر.